Honorable Governor of Odisha, Dr. S. C. Jamir, respected Principal Secretary Tourism, Government of Odisha, Mrs. Arti Ahuja, respected Chairman NALCO and Chairman CII Odisha Chapter, Dr. T.K. Chand, my colleagues, Mr. Deepak Rathor and Mr. Srinivas Sugudi, it is a privilege for me to welcome you all to the dais in the second Odisha Tourism Conclave. It is also a privilege to welcome amongst us the President of the Hotel Association of India and the Managing Director and CEO of the Oberoi Hotels, Mr. Vikram Oberoi. I would also like to take this opportunity to welcome amongst us the President of the Indian Association of Tour Operators, which is the largest travel trade body in the country, Mr. Pranab Sarkar amongst us. I would also like to welcome proud Odia, who has worked all through in different countries as Ambassador of India and retired as Foreign Secretary, Mr. Amarendra Khatua, who is sitting right in front of us. I would also like to welcome our former Tourism Secretary and who worked in the international civil aviation sector, Mr. Vivek Patnaik. We are proud of his contribution in the field of tourism. Friends, during our first tourism conclave held 3 years back, we had made certain recommendations and suggestions to the state government, which resulted in producing one of the most progressive and dynamic tourism policies of the country, which was published last year in 2016. We are sure this would be a great advantage for entrepreneurs and industrialists wishing to invest in the field of tourism and increase the accommodation capacity in the hotel industry. Once we have good hotels spread out over the beautiful tourist locations in the state, the Oberois have got one beautiful hotel in Bhubaneswar. We urge them to come up with more such beautiful hotels in the state. We are sure with good hotels, international chains, the footfalls to the state would definitely take a leap forward. Besides hotel industry, the state government is also giving that for the hotel industry, the state government is in the new tourism policy is giving a lot of incentives for building up water sports infrastructure, boating, cruising, water surfing, and ecotourism. The state government is also giving up to 20% capital investment subsidy to tented accommodation, which is for the first time in any state in India has given. Besides this, the state has also budgeted a 5% interest subsidy for the first time in India, up to a limit of 1 crore to small hoteliers, those who want to invest in the MSME and in the tourism sector. You see, if you are getting a loan of 14% at interest, I think a 5% interest subsidy is a great incentive for us. There is a 100% reimbursement of VAT for a period of 7 years, 100% reimbursement of entertainment tax, exemption from payment of electricity duty for 5 years, reimbursement of entry tax for new hotel projects, 75% reimbursement for male and 100% reimbursement for female workers on payment of ESIC and EPF for a period of 5 years. No state has ever given such an incentive. Training subsidy is introduced for the first time, 2,000 rupees each for employees in new hotels, 75% exemption on registration charges for tourist transport coaches, reimbursement of up to 75,000 rupees for participation overseas fairs and festivals. Second Odisha Tourism Conclave, we have invited not only people from the travel trade, but also important members from CII, from FICCI, from TAI, from Utkal Chamber of Commerce, whose suggestions are important for taking Odisha tourism forward. These members are big industrialists, like you see Chairman Nalco with us. These members can also be considered as prospective investors in the field of tourism. Every hotel room added gives direct employment to 3 people and indirect to additional 10. Odisha is endowed with vast tourism potential and can be a tourist destination far superior to most of the other states which have progressed fast in the tourism sector. And only if this can happen, only if we focus our energies of the government and the private sector in developing the tourism sector. The drain of mineral resources of the state can be avoided if tourism is developed. There is no doubt Odisha is rich with its mineral resources below the soil, but Odisha is much richer with its tourism potential above the soil. Today, India gets about 8 million foreign tourists, which is just 0.7% of the world market, and Odisha gets about the lowest, I think, about 7,000 to 10,000 foreign tourists only, excluding expats and the other business people who come on various corporate activities. When we compare the tourist inflow to India with smaller countries like Singapore, gets 11 million tourists, Thailand 20 million, Hong Kong 30 million foreign tourists. When we look at larger countries like China, it gets 50 million foreign tourists, and USA gets 70 million foreign tourists. As far as the domestic sectors are concerned, India's domestic tourists is 1.7 billion compared to our neighboring country, China. The domestic tourist movement is just double from India, which is 2.5 billion. The theme we have given to this conclave this year is tourism to be the driving force of future economy. We reiterate again that tourism can be the largest employment generator and booster for the Indian GDP, and also having the richest tourism potential in India, Odisha can become the biggest gainer if tourism really taken seriously. As per a report of the Niti Aayog, around 5 crore people are already engaged directly and indirectly in the field of tourism, and with a GDP of INR 6 to 7 lakh crores. The way tourism industry is growing, the figure is likely to double in next 5 years, and Odisha should not lose out. What we propose is government should declare hotels under the infrastructure or industrial status to increase the room capacity in the hotel industry, which in turn will have direct impact on the growth of the tourism sector. India has 0.15 billion classified hotel rooms compared to our biggest neighboring country, China. I repeat, we have 0.15 billion compared to China, which has 2.5 billion classified hotel rooms. With international tourist arrivals with more than 55 million compared to India, which is less than 8 million. The hotel industry in China is doing much better than the hotels in India. Hotel industry is a highly capital intensive industry, and the break-even comes after 8 years on a minimum period. Large amount of capital investment is required, and long-term repayment schedule is the only answer for the growth of the hotel industry in the state. Present mode of financing is a major drawback for the hotel industry, and other than the leading chains, the independent entrepreneurs who take loans, they automatically become NPAs and defaulters because 8 years repayment period is too short. Hotel for hotels, you need minimum 14 to 18 years repayment schedule because this is a really capital investment industry. One suggestion for the state government is, since the principal secretary is here, I would urge her to take our suggestions a little seriously, is building up a convention center. There's a huge market to tap higher value, that is convention and meeting segment. and Odisha badly needs a global standard convention center which can create tremendous intellectual goodwill across different industries and countries. Getting global invest conventions and meetings to India in various technologies, science, engineering, medicine can put Odisha on the world map. The government recently, a few years back, announced that they would, the World Trade Center would come up with a global standard convention center. But this is already 3 years and not much progress has been made. If you compare Odisha with neighboring state Andhra Pradesh, they have got lovely, fantastic international convention center which attracts very big international conferences, and that helps attract a lot of international traffic to Andhra Pradesh. Another segment which has recently come up is the fashion and film tourism. Fashion and film tourism, you see, big corporates, big today, garment business is a big business, and international companies are opening up in India. Everywhere they are doing big fashion shows, and fashion, to look at fashion shows, you have very, very strong high-end international tourist traffic. Same thing is with film tourism. If we can promote Odisha as a film producing destination with our rich tourist scenic places, Odisha can become a hub for big film productions. And I'm happy to announce here, Odisha government has already decided to give 10 lakh subsidy for film producers who produce movies in Odisha. But no single application or nobody has ever approached state government for availing this subsidy. Another suggestion which we would like to put up is Odisha must also start a bird festival. We are all aware Chilka Lake, which is the paradise for millions of migratory birds during the winter season, can attract large segment of bird lovers across the globe. If we can start a bird watching festival in the state to attract the bird lovers, I would like to urge the state government to kindly look into this seriously. Apart from this, yesterday we had a very close meeting with His Excellency Governor of Odisha, who expressed his concern that our culture must be protected. When we promote tourism, the protection of the culture is very important. And we really appreciate his concern that protection of our rich culture and heritage is very important while promoting tourism. We should not become a poor or a third-rate tourist destination. We should always protect our rich culture and heritage while promoting the tourism sector. And Odisha, as you are all aware, is very rich in its culture. The Odissi sarees, the handicrafts, the handloom, the forms of Odissi dances are all things we all Odias know and take pride. But these need to be highlighted in both national and international level to attract footfalls, quality footfalls to our state. Lastly, I would also like to mention here in front of His Excellency that too many frequent changes in the tourism department is one of the major hindrances for continuous growth of tourism. We have too many changes in the secretary and director level, which is pulling the growth of the tourism sector. At least a 3-year term is necessary for continuous tourist growth. If they can do it, it will be good. Otherwise, the government must form a task force to implement a long-term tourism policy, a long-term plan for the growth of tourism to maintain continuity. Unless there is a strong task force, I don't think frequent changes will be helpful for our tourism growth. With these words, I thank once again His Excellency and all members of the media and my colleagues and others who are here present in this August function. Thank you.